if you have the patience, we will take a look at some very key dynamics that will certainly go a long way to free us from our suffering. What is suffering? You see, this is a question. Can we be free of suffering? Absolutely. Absolutely we can. It's actually pure pragmatism. It is time to practice pure pragmatism instead of whimsicality. Suffering is actually whimsicality. All right? And trying to mix pure pragmatism with whimsicality, that's whimsicality too. It's the height of whimsicality. It's like saying trying to mix lies and truth. That's completely whimsical. So, the fact is we have actually been entirely whimsical for many moments. And we need to finally decide, okay, we're going to be actually pragmatic. If you look at this world as the house of whimsicality, what do we do from a pragmatic standpoint? What do we do about this house? We overlay it. We don't change it. We don't learn about it. We don't try to do anything with it at all. We simply overlay it with the perfect no. The perfect no saying, no, we can't. No, never. We can never, I can never be happy here. I can never do anything here. I can never die. I can never learn how to die. Actually, this whole existence is an attempt to learn how to die. Learning is always about death. It's not about anything else. Life doesn't need to learn what it is. It's knowing, not learning. So all learning is an attempt to learn how to die. That is a fact. And so being pragmatic means to actually look at the facts instead of being whimsical. Whimsicality says, we don't need to look at the facts. That's square, man. I mean, let's be groovy and whimsical, and we don't need facts. What do we need facts for? Well, that's convenient if you still want to try and believe that you can die, meaning that you can become prime creator. That's the whole purpose of this death training program. But it's completely whimsical because you cannot. It's futile. So really, existence is a dance of whimsicality, designed to learn how to die. So seeing this as it is pragmatic. See, the whimsical can never see itself because it says that's pragmatic. The whimsical never sees itself for what it is. It's always avoiding seeing what it is. That's the whimsicality. Whimsicality says, I don't need to. I can do this forever. Whimsicality. I can do this dance forever, and I can find a way to be happy, and I can find a way to succeed, and I can find a way to always be completely whimsical and never have to deal with reality, the facts of reality. That's whimsicality. It's not a fact at all. It's whimsicality being totally whimsical. So this dance of whimsicality is going to become, it's already become, it's always a nightmare, but it's becoming very intense right now. So we really, it's a great time to decide to become pragmatic. Let's decide to be pragmatic. What are the facts? So if you're wondering what is the struggle on the path, it's between this whimsicality and pragmatism. And the whimsical keeps saying to the pragmatic, hey, you can do both. Hey, you can do both. How can you have pure whimsicality and at the same time have pure pragmatism? Okay. And isn't it whimsical to say that you can have partial facts? That is whimsicality. That's like saying you can have partial reality. It's that which we must say no to. The perfect no says no to the whimsicality. Seamless blanket overlay. Christ means oil, anointed with oil. That's the overlay. It's the perfect no to whimsicality. The perfect pragmatism. No, we cannot learn how to die. No, we don't need learning. Because all learning is to try to learn how to die. No, we can't. Okay. Seamless blanket overlay. It's not partial overlay. Total overlay. The whimsical says, well, why don't you just overlay some of it and leave the rest? It's not effective. That just makes things worse, or keeps the status quo going. Of, hey, we can have partial truth. That's whimsicality. That's insanity, but we call it whimsicality, because that's a better description, because we're not really insane. Spirit mind can never be insane, but it can be extremely whimsical. It's choosing to be. Of course, choosing the idea of wanting to be prime creator is an excursion into total whimsicality. That's all it is. So from a pragmatic standpoint, we say, look, let's say the world is a house, and we say, well, you know what, I'm not going to see your house anymore. And they say, well, you won't learn about my house. That's right. I don't need any learning anymore. I don't need learning. That's whimsical. Learning is whimsical. I'm not going to get rid of your house. I'm not going to destroy your house. I'm just going to overlay your house. That's all. And I'm not going to see it anymore. I'm going to see the overlay of your house. And the whimsical will say, but look, I've got such nice tile. And look at my you know, wood flooring. It's this awesome wood flooring I have. My beautiful stainless steel appliances. You should see my house, how nice it is. And maybe you can give me some tips how to make it better. Say, no, I'm not interested in giving tips to whimsicality. I'm interested in seeing the overlay, the perfect no to whimsicality, the perfect no. Because that's pragmatic. Perfection is pragmatic, because that reminds us of reality. And that's the only facts there are the facts of reality. There are no other facts. So we say, no, we're going to overlay your house, and we're going to see the overlay. And of course, the Hausfrau doesn't like that. Says, look at my house. It's so beautiful. It's so wonderful. You need to learn how to maintain it. You need to learn how to fix it. You need to learn how to remodel it, make it better. And we say, no, I'm only interested in seeing the overlay of your house. And whatever activity is taking place, it doesn't matter. I'm not interested in learning anything about it. I'm only interested in experiencing, perceiving, and experiencing the overlay of your house. The entire world, the entire universe, overlaid. We're only seeing that. Abiding in that. Not learning. There's nothing to learn. You simply abide in it. Again, learning is whimsicality. And we've decided pragmatism. See, Ramana Maharshi, for instance, was a pure pragmatist. Pure pragmatist. It's us that are whimsical. Whimsical. Totally whimsical. Ananda Maima said this world is an insane asylum, meaning people here are given over to extreme whimsicality and disregard the facts, disregard what works, disregard pragmatism, disregard seeing that the continuity problem is the only problem that we have. Just completely disregarding, as they say, well, I don't need to deal with facts. Facts are whatever I want to believe in. So it's a great time to accept the overlay. Now, I had a dream last night where this was taking place, and the Hausfrau was screaming at me. Says, you got to tell me what you're doing in my house. This is my house. I say, well, fine, it's your house, but the overlay is my overlay, you see. So you, sure, it's your house. I don't care. But that's not germane to the situation. I'm choosing to overlay the house, you see, and see the overlay instead. And so this is the tug of war that we have within us. And it needs to be resolved in favor of the pragmatic, pure pragmatism. And we're turning the tables on. See, the world insists that it's pragmatic. About learning about the world is pragmatic. Well, it would be pragmatic if the goal of existence were possible. But since the goal of existence is impossible, it's purely whimsical. Purely whimsical. So we can't let whimsicality turn the tables on us, which is what it's done. Right? That's what happened to me. I mean, coming into this world, I said, no, I'm going to remain purely pragmatic. And eventually, the world turned the tables on me and said that my stance was whimsical and the world's stance was pragmatic. So it flipped it upside down. That happens to just about everybody. So it's nothing to be ashamed of. It's something you need to admit. That's called repentance. Repentance is just admitting that you've had things flipped upside down and you have taken the viewpoint of whimsicality as being pragmatic, which is false. It's not a fact. So spiritual path is really being one of repentance, one of admittance, saying, yeah, I did get it flipped. You know, I wasn't able to keep abiding in facts. And so now I'm pushing back and trying to get back to facts, trying to get back to pragmatism. Pragmatism means what works. What works? What works is to have the continuity problem resolved for us. That's what works. So the overlay resolves the continuity issue for us. It reminds us of reality, because reality, there is no death, there is no attempt to die, there is no learning, there is no perception, there's none of any of that. But the perfect no is a beautiful gift of remembrance from the prime creator, actually. And of course the whimsicality just ignores it completely. Ignores it completely. And insists that it's being pragmatic. It's not. Because you must look at the premise. Whimsicality says that the way to die is to remain completely whimsical. No, it doesn't work. All you do is remain whimsical. You don't die. So if you want to remain in this totally whimsical state, continue on with this believing that whimsicality is pragmatic. That is the whimsical state. All right? So believing that whimsicality is pragmatic is the whimsical state. That's it. Meaning, whimsicality saying that it can succeed. No, it just remains whimsical. It doesn't succeed at anything. It never becomes anything other than what it is, which is pursuing a futility, futile quest. So I woke up this morning and aware of this, I had all this overlay material. I was going to overlay the house, and the house for how I was very upset. See, you never tell me what you're doing. What are you doing in my house? Well, I'm not doing anything in your house. I'm overlaying your house, you see. Overlayment. So I don't have to look at your house. See, looking at the world is looking at pure whimsicality. It is. The world is just nothing but total whimsicality of all this impermanence. All this impermanence as if it's a dance of whimsicality saying, hey, look. Look at this presumption that death can happen in this tree. This tree is a presumption that death can happen. All of this is just a presumption, an imagination, a mirage. See, all this will eventually add up to a death, to the death of reality. No, it doesn't add up to anything. The world doesn't add up to anything. It's a zero. It's a zero now. It'll always be a zero. The impossible is always a zero. It'll never happen. So, we've gone over all this before, but still there's this tug of war, right? Yeah, absolutely, that is the conflict with the struggle, is, of course, whimsicality will insist that the pragmatic is insane and is totally whimsical. Like, you can never succeed. Well, see, we don't need to succeed except to solve the continuity problem. The only success that we need is to solve the continuity problem, to have that resolved for us. That's it. Reality is already real. Facts are already facts. We don't need to succeed at facts. We only need to be reminded of facts and accept them and drop whimsicality. So the overlay indeed is successful in dropping whimsicality. It's the cure for whimsicality. And of course, whimsicality says, I don't need a cure. I can stay this way forever. Well, that's not a fact. That's not a fact. That is not a fact. Because facts cannot be changed. Reality is what is forever. Dreams can never be forever. So we have this tug of war going on. And spending time looking at this is super valuable, super valuable. So I thought I'd get up this morning and not waste any time and get right to what is truly valuable in this world. The only thing that's valuable is to repent, is to acknowledge that you had the tables turned on you coming into this world. Of course, we don't want that to happen. I didn't want it to happen. I fought against it. You know, it took about 12 years finally to have the tables flipped on me. Fought against it, you know, tremendously, but was unable to prevail because it's just whimsicality is you know, you might call it pure insanity. And it very difficult to prevail. And yet we must, and yet we must. And I do believe it is possible. That's what the teachers have told us, that those who have done it have told us, yes, it is possible, but it's not easy. And yet we're doing it right here. We're actually doing it by looking at it and saying, yeah, we do have a problem with this whimsicality, and it's not able to see at all properly. It's insane or whimsical, completely whimsical, impractical, completely impractical. Continuing on with existence is completely impractical. There's zero. What is practical is being reminded of reality. That's what's practical. Reminded of facts. Being reminded of the fact we can't die. That's the number one fact we need to be reminded of. Hey, we can't die. That's only a dream, a whimsical dream. We cannot die. We need to be reminded of this fact. So looking at this world doesn't remind us of that at all, that this house that we're dwelling in doesn't remind us of that at all. It only reminds us of whimsicality. So we need to see something other than the house, which is the overlay. But we don't want to move out of the house. You see, that's our comfort zone. We're used to it, familiar. So we still dwell in the house, as it were, but we don't see the house. We see the overlay of the house. It's like you have a beautiful hardwood floor, and you decide, I'm going to overlay this floor with overlayment, and then you don't see the floor anymore. But the overlayment is way more beautiful than the wood floor, actually. So it's still there. The world is still here. It just, we don't see it. We're not perceiving. We're seeing the overlay of it. But we can still walk on the floor. When you put overlayment on the floor, wood floor, the floor's still there. You're still walking on it. You're functioning fine. It's you're just perceiving something way more beautiful than the floor. So we're going to perceive something. The tree is still there, but now we're perceiving it as way more beautiful. The overlay is way more beautiful than the tree without the overlay. And it reminds us of reality. So here we go with this continued effort, and we might ask ourselves, how come it's so difficult? Well, habit, bad habits, fear, pressure, demands, it's turned out to be difficult. There's no question about that. It would be untrue to say that it has not been difficult. And yet we're at the point now where we're able to finally succeed. And I guess we don't want to admit that we've been taken on this long, strange trip by whimsicality, because it's kind of, you know, you feel kind of ashamed by it. Like, wow, why did I have such a difficult time? Well, let's just leave that aside at this point. Just leave it aside. And continue on with focusing on the remedy. All right, focus on the remedy. So each one of us goes through the day, we're still seeing the world, we're still maintaining, feeling we need to maintain something. We need to build something, we need to remodel, maintain, clean up the dust and all that stuff, the dirt, everything. We need to make it better, we need to keep changing it, all that stuff. And then inside us, we feel, no, I only need to see everything. Maybe I can do both. And we know that's not it. And we look around for others who have succeeded, and we don't see it. And therefore, it gets frightening. I do that. I look on YouTube. I look wherever I've always looked. Very little success, actually, on this issue. But very little. That shows you the what whimsicality, the fear that it engenders. Because really, the idea of being Prime Creator is totally whimsical. And to pursue this, we must generate this incredible cloud of confusion and whimsicality and try to stick with it. And as long as whimsicality says we can always be this way, so we keep thinking if we just stick with it, it will succeed. But the idea at this point is how to minimize the time that we continue on with this. That's my focus here. How do we get it today, right now? See, right now is pragmatic. Right now means whimsicality doesn't work at all. Right now means you can't mix truth and lies. You can't have partial facts. Can't have partial facts. So in other words, saying right now, what's wrong with right now, as you know, some teachers say, what's wrong with right now? Meaning, what's wrong with facts? What's wrong with facts? Because facts are right now. They're not partial. They're not part of them that needs to become a fact or learn how to be a fact or learn how to be factual. No, facts are facts right now. So the overlayment is, if some say it's like the now, right now. Facts are right now. They're not based on time. The overlay is an overlay right now. It's not waiting to become an overlay. So we see the overlay right now. And this is something that we have to keep struggling with here and looking at. The overlay doesn't need any time to become something that it isn't, or to become partial. We say, well, the overlay needs time to become partial. That's whimsicality. Okay, again, that's whimsicality. That's like saying reality needs time to become unreal. Facts need time to become untrue. Now, it doesn't matter how much time you give them, give it, it's facts are still facts. So during this day, I will make a resolve to continue to search for what is truly relevant, remain calm, remain focused on this, and actually make prayers to the Holy Spirit, saying that you're willing to look at it the way the Holy Spirit looks at it. Now, I know that I've been clearer in the past about this whole situation, and so it's frustrating, right? When you get up in the day and you say, "Wow, I'm just not as clear as I was a little while ago." A little while ago, I was so close to getting it, but I didn't. That's frustrating. Very frustrating. What I have found is that if you keep your calm and focus on being pragmatic, that the next moment of clarity will be much greater, actually. Much greater. I know there's been a ton of breakthroughs in the past, so you just have to believe that all of that is fermenting there. That's the wine. That's the fermentation process. And the next breakthrough is going to be colossal. It's going to be, you know, much, much bigger, and maybe it will stick. It will stick. It seems to indicate that the overlayment is coming, because the dream was, it was all the materials, over the materials of hearing was, you know, start spread them out and say, let's now, we're going to overlay everything. So, goodbye to whimsicality. It's probably like a, you know, you're sort of saying a fond farewell, or a not so fond farewell to whimsicality, and try not to get too much into it. I've been doing some graphic work recently that's really, you know, amazing, but it's kind of like a maybe a farewell to whimsicality. So maybe a lot of the effort is just to sustain a steady steadiness, right? Because sort of there's a realization within that it's goodbye to the world of whimsicality. It's goodbye to that. And there's sort of a feeling like, wow, I've been with it so long, I want to, you know, take some time to give a farewell to it, that kind of thing. And the effort is just to not go overboard in that. So that's maybe where all the effort is right now. It's not so much on the insights. I think I've already had those insights, and I already know the truth. It's just that there's this, have to remain docile, focused, steady, not going crazy with anything. There's a desire to grab my camera and just go down the coast of California and, you know, videotape all the waves and nature and stuff, or do these incredible graphics, which I have been doing, of wrapping words around images and doing different colors, and it's like, wow. And, you know, just go on a whim, on a lark. Just there's this feeling like, just let me just grab my camera and just take off and, you know, go protest in front of, you know, stand up on the corner, the end is near, just do something, you know, whimsical, a final burst of whimsicality. And so there's this great effort to not do that. So that's probably consuming my energy and attention, and I'm not able to direct it so clearly to the root. You know, I'm able to do it, you know, to some extent, but not that real sharp clarity. It is not there right at this moment. So I think that's probably the explanation. I would say for all of you, consider this, that you're restraining yourself from a final burst of whimsicality. Final burst of whimsicality. And I could do a lot of stuff, actually, with music and graphics and video and words, everything. I could do, I could become in clothing, I could become very whimsical at this point. And so there's this just a tremendous effort to stay focused on what is actually pragmatic, what actually works, because we can't afford to waste any more time. The dance of the world is just, you know, it's constantly changing. It's you know, it's now a boogie or a cha-cha or whatever. It's you know, a boogaloo. Maybe we're going into, the world's going into the boogaloo, probably. How about the bugaloo? The cometaloo, the comet grade, comet dance, or whatever. It's the dance is coming, and the dance is just changing so fast, you know. It's like, wow, I can't dance that dance. don't try. Just choose the overlay. Be pragmatic. Finally, be pragmatic. I'm finally going to do what is pragmatic. And I think, like for instance, for example, my own life, I feel like this feeling that I've never really been pragmatic. Right? When I was young, I was. Once I lost, you know, got overwhelmed by this whimsicality, insisting that it was pragmatic, I've never been pragmatic since, which is a real regret. I keep saying, just once in my life, since that I, you know, flipped, for once in my life, let's be pragmatic. Just let's be pragmatic. Just one time. Just once. Come on. You know, living, you know, since you were turned inside out, upside down by whimsicality, living your entire life that way is, again, completely whimsical. Completely stupidly whimsical. So definitely don't want to do that. And as all these troubles are coming now, rushing at us, there's a feeling like, hey, you know what? We've got to get this done now. Tomorrow is going to be too late. It could be, you know, whimsicality could live your entire life. It's just an exercise in whimsicality that is just so regretful, really. So how to stay just grounded in everydayness, not trying to do anything too bizarre. Maybe a little stuff, you'll do a little something that is a little bit whimsical. But, you know, limit it. You might feel like I suddenly need to get all my savings account, get an RV, travel across the country. Just gotta, no. Because the overlay, we can see it right where we are. It's total. And that is very possible. Don't need to go visiting the sites of the Grand Canyon and all these things. I have to say no. We have something way better than that. We don't need to take a grand tour of the house. The house of this world. We're going to accept the overlay of this world and see that. All right. Stay grounded, stay focused, and keep yourself steady inquiry. Very urgent that you have steady inquiry and just keep on, just stay with it, and the breakthrough is probably going to come. That's how I feel. It's probably right there. All right, that's it.